Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 8. This is Section 9.3, Problem Number 8. It says a large automotive dealership in Fall River wants a 90% confidence interval for the proportion of their customers that will buy a vehicle from them again in the future. They have no estimate of the proportion to start the study, and they would like to have a margin of error of 0.04. How big a sample do they need? So the formula to determine sample size is n equals p hat times 1 minus p hat times z sub c over capital E raised to the second power. So now to fill this in, we start with p hat, and it says right in the question, they have no estimate of the proportion to start the study. It's not really a problem. When this happens, and it can happen, what you want to do is use 0.5 for your p hat. And what that's going to do is it's going to overestimate the size of the sample you need a little bit, which will give you a little bit more accuracy. So if you have a good estimate, go ahead and put it in for p hat, and if you don't, just go with 0.5. So our formula will fill in p hat, we're going to use 0.5, times 1 minus p hat, so 1 minus 0.5, times z sub c. Z sub c is the confidence coefficient, and for 90% confidence, which is what they tell us to use in this problem, the confidence coefficient would be 1.645. There's a little chart for that in the notes, and you can look it up. 90% confidence matches up with a confidence coefficient z sub c of 1.645. The E in the denominator is given in the question as 0.04. They would like to have a margin of error of 0.04. Close the parentheses. Don't forget the second power. That's kind of a common mistake. And that's how the formula fills in. So now I can go ahead and start the math. So I will have N equals 0.5 from here times 1 minus 0.5 in the next set of parentheses. That will be 0.5 again. Times 1.645 divided by 0.04. That's something you're probably going to want to use a calculator for. It's 1.645 divided by 0.04. And I can get started without a calculator. It's 41.125. That's the result of the division. So 41.125 in parentheses raised to the second power. You can't forget that second power. So getting a little bit closer, 0.5 times 0.5 in front of the second power there, you're going to have n is 0.25. Now, 41.125 second power, that's getting a little beyond what I feel comfortable doing without a calculator. So you'll have to do 41.125 times 41.125. That's what they mean by second power. So my calculator will help me with that. 41.125 times 41.125 is 1,691.265625. That's more decimals than I need, but just let it run for now and we'll round it once at the end. So now the result of 1,691.265625 gets multiplied times the 0.25 in front of it. I still have the 1,691 point something on the screen of my calculator, so I just leave it and say times 0.25 equals. And the calculator tells me the answer is 422.816,4063. Now, the notes for this section say that when you use the determine the sample size formula and you get a decimal result, you always want to round up to the next biggest whole number. So 422.8 would ordinarily round up anyway, but even if it was, say, 422.3, you'd still bring it up to the next nearest whole number. So my final answer is 423. So how many car buyers does this big dealership need in their survey to get the confidence interval with the level of confidence they want? They would need 423.